Understand, I am a most powerful, strong nuclear force, positive explosion. Only based on the effect, impact I create on all of you and in the universe, the result only can be described as my story. How will you write the history of a lightning? Tell me. How will you? No. Based on the impact it makes, you pen down the history of lightning. Same way. Just only based on the impact. I call it Divya Sarira I am making in each one of you. Only through that collective narration of the impact I make on this universe can only be described, used to detail my story. I can give you some incidents. Of course, you will be hearing a lot of incidents from my blood relatives, family, friends. I tell you, every person who walks in the street in Thiruvannamalai will have some story about me. They are so happy to connect. Some way they will tell my fathers, grandfathers, grandsons, cousins, second sisters, third granddaughters, fathers. Fifth grandson is a classmate of Swamiji. They are so happy that there is some connection. And just like how I celebrate Thiruvannamalai celebrates me. You will hear a lot of stories, a lot of incidents. An ordinary photographer who has a small photograph shop, a small rented property, just 20 feet by 20 feet. He has not only stories, thorough evidence that he has seen with his own eyes, Raghupati Yogi levitating, me levitating, Raghupati Yogi trying to photograph when I am levitating on that. That photographer's assistants got frightened, ran away. And the photograph did not fall. The body was in such high frequency. Light can never be captured by the camera. And the photograph did not come out. It was just empty. Then again they have to click, making me sit on the ground. You will hear every person telling the stories. We have at least 3 eyewitness. One person who makes flower garland in Thiruvannamalai temple, Krithigai Mandapam. Second, the photographer who took the photograph of Arunagiri Yogi and me. Third, Raghupati Yogi's son. All these 3 of them are the eyewitness for me levitating, floating on the air. You can see all of them. You can get the narration from each of them directly. You can enjoy the stories. And leelas. And you should all visit my guru's samadhis. The Yoga Lingam we installed on my Guru Yogi Raghupati Yogi Yogananda Puri Samadhi and Vibhudananda Puri Samadhi. We have installed Shivalingam and there are so many other places to be seen in Thiruvannamalai, associated to my life. You should also visit the Anandaganda Guha, the cave of Arunachaleshwara's Anandaganda. through which Arunagiri Yogeshwara used to take me. See, he will walk me into his samadhi and get me out through the Arunagiri Yogesh, the Anandaganda Guha. We have one photograph taken on me sitting on that cave. The cave is just near the Skandashram of Ramanashram. Ramanashram has a branch on the hill called Skandashram, where Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi sat for a long time, lived for a long time. Just near that Skandashram, that Anandaganda Guha, the cave of Anandaganda of Arunachala is there. You should all visit that place also. And continuously there is a natural waterfall, water fountain. It used to be live 365 days waterfall in those days. I don't know now whether it is still live, but surely there is a small water pond. It used to be there. As long as I lived in Arunachala, it was gift from Arunagiri Yogeshwara for me, because I used to go there and sit and meditate for a long time and sit in samadhi with Arunagiri Yogeshwara, oneness in Arunagiri Yogeshwara. You should visit all those places. It will be intensely charging experience to hear the stories and eyewitness. See, one thing, the innocent, straightforward, heart-to-heart narration from those small town villagers, it has become town only now. In those days when I was born and brought up, it was not a town. It was a little bigger village, that's all. As per Indian standard, it was only a little bigger village. That's all. It was not a town. So, the innocent, straightforward, heart-to-heart stories from those villages, that is the authenticity of that stories. Authenticity of that stories. Understand? Nothing can corrupt those villagers. How much ever they hear from the media, they don't care. They say very clearly, hey, we know Swamiji. He grew up here. And they don't even say he grew up here. They always say, we brought him up. Every villager in Thiruvannamalai, whether he is a small fruit shop vendor or seller of camphor, everyone will have some story. And I tell you, all of them have brought me up. All of them have brought me up. All of them are directly involved in bringing me up. All of them have brought me up. It is extreme love, care, and that spiritual ecosystem of Thiruvannamalai